Good morning, students. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the lesson Vijayanagara and the Bahumani Kingdoms, 9th Standard Social Syllabus History Part. Let us see the fill in the blanks with suitable words. The Vijayanagara Empire was established in the year 1336 AD. Hakka and Bukka were the established by this Vijayanagara Empire. The Madura Vijaya was written by the Ganga Devi. Madura Vijaya was written by Ganga Devi. Prouda Devaraya's minister was Lakkanna Dandesha. The king who wrote Amukta Molyada in Telugu was Krishna Devaraya. The king who wrote Amukta Molyada in Telugu was written by Krishna Devaraya. Madrasa at Bidar was established by Muhammad Gawan. Kutubi Navaras was written by Ibrahim Adil Shah II. Answer the following questions. Name the four dynasties who ruled by Vijayanagara Empire. Four dynasties who ruled by Vijayanagara Empire as the Sangama, Salva, Tuluva and Aravidu. What were the achievements of Devaraya II? He defeated the King Gajapati Kapilendra of Orissa and seized the Kondavidu. He expanded his kingdom up to Krishna River in the north and east, surprising the regional leader of the border. He defeated the King Gajapati Kapilendra of Orissa and seized the Kondavidu. He expanded his kingdom up to Krishna River in the north and east, surprising the regional leader of the border. So, he defeated in Kerala and state and received the royalties from the royal Kerala and the Sri Lanka. Hence, he came to known as the Dakshinapatha Chakravarti, the emperor of the south. He chased the traditional and the Ahmad Shah of the Bahumani till Bijapur and occupied the Mudugal and the Bankapura. His commander Lakkanna Dandesha took up a successful navy victory. What were the problems Krishnadevaraya had to face when he ascended the throne? When Krishnadevaraya came to power, the king was besieged by various complex international and external problems. The Europeans who had arrived through the new sea routes had established the colonies. His commander Lakkanna Dandesha took successful naval victory. What were the problems Krishnadevaraya had to face when he ascended the throne? When Krishnadevaraya came to power, the king was besieged and various complex internal and external problems. The Europeans who had arrived through new sea routes and established the colonies. The Mughals of the north were trying to expand their kingdom in the southern region. The five Shahi kingdoms and the Bahumani dynasty become powerful sultanates and plugged into war against the Krishnadevaraya, and the king of Umathuru and Varissa were the contest source of thrust. What were the contributions of the Vijayanagara Empire at the economic system of the society? Land tax was the main source of the revenue for the kingdom. Farmers gave 1/4 of their income to the government as the tax. Professional tax, revenue tax and the road tax, market tax, commercial tax, import and export taxes and the tributes from the vassals were the other forms of the revenue to the kingdom. Agriculture was the backbone of the economy. Many important food and cash crops were grown. Many wells, tanks, canals were constructed for the irrigation purpose. There were the great programs in the field of the industries and the commerce. Spices like the pepper, cloves, cardamom, salt, petra, iron ore, diamonds, granite, sugar, sandal, perfume were exported. There were many textile industries. Coins of the different denominations like gold coins, gadhyana, pagoda, silver coins and the copper coins were used. There were diamonds and iron ore centers, sapphires used to be available in plenty. Countries like Arab, China and Portugal had the trade relations with the Vijayanagara Empire. The society was based on the four-tiered caste system. However, there were also occupation-based caste systems. There were many skills in the artisans, blacksmiths, bell metal smiths. Describe the art and architecture of the Vijayanagara period. The unique feature of the Vijayanagara architecture was the construction of the huge auditorium and the marriage halls. The temples are the huge towers, Raya Gopura, leaf-shaped arches and platforms. In this art, more than ornamentation, the qualities of the grandeur, awe and elegance were given importance. Rough granite stones used for the construction of these structures. The temples were built in the Hampi, Sringeri, Tirupati, Lepakshi, Kerala, Batkal, Kanchi, Srishaila, Kolar, etc. The most important temple was the Vijayanagara temple at Sringeri, which was also a unique structure. Explain the education, art and architecture of the Bahumani Sultanates. The educational policy of the Sultanates was the propagate of the schools known as the Maktubs. They were under the control of the Masjids. The students in the Maktubs were taught the alphabet, religion, law, poetry and Ridaik. The Madaras were the centers of the higher education. Muhammad Gawan, who was the scholar himself, established the Madaras College at Bidar. It had a library with around 3,000 manuscripts. The college was a lodge for students, teachers and the orthodox peoples. Astronomy, grammar, mathematics, philosophy and political science were studied in the college. So, art and architecture, the Bahumani Sultanates develops the Indo-Saracenic style of the architecture. The Jamia Masjid built by the Adil Shah first, Ibrahim Roza, Gol Gumbaz, Gawan Mahal and the Azhar Mahals are the important world-famous monuments. The Gol Gumbaz at Bijapur is one of the greatest structures in the world. It has an area of 1,800 square feet. There are 7 storied minarets in the 4 corners of the building. There are a huge dome in the center. The unique feature of this dome is that is one whispers standing on the side of the dome. It can be heard clearly on the other side. It is the biggest dome in India. So these are regarding the Vijayanagara and the Bahumani Kingdom, the important question and answers for the examination purpose. Dear students, let us see with the next video. I hope that you can make use of